I'm going to show you how to run scheduled jobs on Heroku. So we're going to start by running a rake task every 10 minutes or so. So I've created a rake task here where it just calls this job, calls perform now. The job just spits out some stuff to the logs, so nothing too fancy. And when I run rake-t looking for it, it is just this command here, log create random. So let's start off by going to the scheduler. We're going to add Heroku scheduler as an add-on. This is like kind of their little tool to manage these tasks. It's only got one tier and it's free. Cool, we've got it. So we're going to go into here. We're going to select create job. We're going to put in the rake task and we're going to say every 10 minutes. Awesome, there it is, and it will run every 10 minutes. This approach is fine, but if we were to go redeploy our app, we'd have to add these all manually again. And also, in our local development, they're not running anymore, so like, we could end up in a scenario where our development environment deviates an awful lot from our production. So we're going to remove this, and instead, delete that add-on. Instead, we're going to use Sidekiq Cron. It's a gem which will really complement our Sidekiq worker. What it does is it just handles the queuing of like those jobs we want to run and at the time we're going to run them. You can configure it from a hash or a YAML file with like a little snippet. Let's jump in. So in my gem file, I've already kind of added it in there. I've also set up a initializer. And you can copy this from the repo. I'll chuck the link to it in the show notes. And what I've pretty much done here is if we've got this gem defined, make sure we add the web UI for it. It'll also load a YAML file stored in config/schedule with all of our scheduled jobs stored within it. And then we just kind of let it do its thing. Let's have a look at the schedule. Okay, so we've got something already kind of set up. I'm going to change this job to be log create random and the queue is going to be default. And I'm also going to change that to be create random blog. And this is a little bit cryptic. It's a cron tab expression. The trick to kind of understanding these is to go to a tool like this, cron tab guru. And it'll just kind of tell you when we're going to run it. So I'm going to tell it to run at a 59th minute at 11 o'clock, because that's pretty near to now. Okay, let's commit that up. Get this. Okay. Scheduling the random blog creation. Okay, and we're going to let that deploy out. So we can see Heroku is going to pick up on it in just a moment. There it is. Awesome, it's just deployed out. If we open our app now and go to Sidekiq and then go cron, we get a nice UI to kind of look at our cron jobs. And we can see that there's our little job queued up, ready to go, and it's going to run in about a minute's time for me, which is pretty awesome. The reason I like this is because with this file being in version control, if we were to move off Heroku or go to a different service, we could actually not have to reconfigure anything, which is really good. We could just say, oh, okay, we're going to have to run Sidekiq anyway. This will just queue those jobs up to run. So in this case, they're actually just running in the worker here we've got set up, which is really nice. And that job's actually about to run. Let's watch it go out. Nice, so there it is. You can kind of see the logged output we had from the original job and all the other little bits around it, such as it being queued and it being marked as completed. And then the UI is also updated to say when it was last enqueued. That's pretty good. That is the end of this video. I'm hoping you found that useful and enjoyable. I am MikeRogers0 on Twitter. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a message or drop a little comment underneath this video. Thank you for watching, and I will catch you next time.